For the past 20 years, Ruth Hanesian has been a bird breeder and pet store owner in Rockville, Maryland. She's now written a book called Birds on the Couch, The Bird Shrink's Guide to Keeping Polly from Going Crackers and You Out of the Cuckoo's Nest.
If you could put a little red warning label on each parrot cage, what would it say?
I am a bird. I have my own thoughts. I have my own way of expressing myself. I'm verbal. I will make noise. I will see what's going on in your household and have an opinion about it.
Stop it. You can hear yourself.
I will be in charge of your life if you let me be.
You write, will you freak out if Polly screams during dinner parties? What if she learns to mimic your lovemaking cries and repeats them when your mother-in-law comes for a visit? Can't be.
Oh, can be. If you decide to get a bird, you have to watch what you say around it. Because they will pick up the things that you really don't want them to say.
Oh, stop.
Now, Ruth, you're pushing it on the next one. Birds can be codependents. What are we talking about here?
They get very involved with you, and they get very upset when you're not there. It's like having a two-year-old child for the rest of your life.
And by the way, the rest of their lives can be a very long time. If taken care of properly, the bigger birds can live up to 100 years. And that's just fine with Connie Pavlinak. She and her husband, Gary, are the proud parents of three birds. And Connie makes sure all of her birds' needs are taken care of. First, their meals. Connie spends at least an hour and a half each day chopping fruits and vegetables for the older birds, then mixing formula for the baby, making sure it's not too hot and hand-feeding him. Then another hour and a half sweeping floors and scrubbing and cleaning cages. And twice a week there are the showers, followed by a fluff drive. And they have emotional needs.
Hi.
They need to be talked to. They need to be held. They need to be stimulated, so if we talk to them, we entertain them with toys.
Bonnie Kank runs the Parrot Education and Adoption Center in San Diego. In the last 2 years, she has taken in more than 100 unwanted birds, including this conure whose owner couldn't tolerate her constant screaming and kept her in a covered cage in a dark room for 6 years. You see, birds become quiet in the dark. With nothing to do and nothing to see, little Audrey turned on herself and started plucking out her own feathers.
It's really very, very sad that people just don't understand what they're getting into when they get a bird. Conures are relatively noisy birds.
How often, Bonnie, do you see a problem result because of an impulse purchase?
Daily. That's how we end up with most of our birds.
Parrots are the worst impulse purchase in the world, and they're so frequently purchased on impulse because they're so beautiful and they're so endearing in pet stores. You need to do your homework before buying a parrot. They are very, very, very smart. They have very, very long memories.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye-bye. They're amazing animals.
Good night. Good night, bird. Good night.